Scottish First Minister Nicola Sturgeon tried to downplay claims of a political rift between Scotland and Downing Street after Andrew Marr grilled her on the potential split in how the two sides deal with the coronavirus pandemic. Nicola Sturgeon revealed that she would break with the UK if necessary, but tried to downplay claims of a political rift in the responses from Scotland and Downing Street. Speaking to the BBC's Andrew Marr, the Scottish First Minister said it was right that there was as much consistency as possible between the Scottish and UK government response to the outbreak. She confirmed plans to diverge from rest of the UK in lifting lockdown measures if necessary, but stressed this decision is not political in any way, shape or form. Earlier this week, the SNP leader stunned officials in Downing Street after releasing a detailed 25-page plan setting out how lockdown measures could be eased in the future. However, critics pointed out that she appeared to copy the principles laid out by Dominic Raab in Westminster. This sparked claims that Mrs. Sturgeon was trying to usurp the authority in Westminster, which, Marr told the SNP leader, it does look like as if Scotland might lift the lockdown in a slightly different way with different regulations than England. In those circumstances, do you have the power to close the border if you need to? She responded, I don't have the power to close the borders. But those are conversations we want to keep having with the UK government, on the question of Scotland doing things differently, not for the sake of it, we want. Only if the evidence and judgments tell us that is necessary. Mrs. Sturgeon explained, if, and it is an if, I am not saying that we're likely to get into this territory, the UK government took decisions that I thought were premature in terms of coming out of the lockdown then clearly I would want to make sure that Scotland did what I judged was best to protect the population. Nicola Sturgeon went on to admit that her own Scottish government had made mistakes, as she refused to criticise the Westminster response to the virus. She said, we can undoubtedly get things wrong along the way, as every government across the world make mistakes, everybody involved in leading these responses will make mistakes, but it's really important we take the best decisions we can at every single stage and try to learn from that as we go. This comes after an SNP MP Stuart Hosey claimed the UK government's reaction to the outbreak had been botched and shambolic. In a press release from the SNP, Mr. Hosey said the UK government had been far too slow, far too late, and far too chaotic in its approach so far. The SNP leader has also come under fire this morning after reports revealed she had missed 6 coronavirus COBRA meetings at the onset of the coronavirus outbreak. The SNP's Westminster leader Ian Blackford had previously condemned Boris Johnson following news he had missed 5 COBRA meetings. When the news about Mr. Johnson broke, Mr. Blackford described his non-attendance.